the reconciliation is based on two or three basic things: truth, justice, and confession. In order for the victim of genocide to forgive the perpetrator of the genocide, he must come and say, "I made a mistake. I am sorry. I ask forgiveness, and I commit myself that I will not repeat it ever in the future." In Bosnia and Herzegovina, regarding this genocide in Srebrenica, we don't hear that. We hear, on the other hand, the denial of evil, denial of the sin. And not only that, but those who committed this sin of genocide and who were sanctioned by the international law in The Hague, they are now like trophies of those who are trying to cover up their crime. In the Quran, there is a small phrase which says, "But if you forgive, God will forgive your sins in the hereafter." So when I explain to the mothers this phrase in the Holy Quran, this was the painkiller of their soul. So the faith is the only painkiller of the soul and the spirit. And therefore, I am very proud of my people in Bosnia and Herzegovina, how they coped with this genocide, post-genocide syndrome, and calling for, it is interesting when the victims call for reconciliation more powerfully than those who committed the crime of genocide. All in all, I am very proud that not one single revenge happened connected with genocide in Bosnia and Herzegovina so far.